السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome back my friend to my YouTube channel Drilling and Workover. This is Abdelaziz Gabr. I am accredited instructor in IWCF Well Control and IEDC Well Sharp. Also, I am accredited instructor in IEDC Mud Engineering for Basic and Advanced Mud School. Today, inshallah, we will continue to talk about the clay chemistry. And there are here today we will talk about yesterday we have talked about the types of clays, and today we will talk about the type of reaction or the type of interactions that happens or that could happen to the clay. The swelling mechanism. The swelling happens to the clay in fresh water, or what the meaning here by fresh water to the clay? The clay fresh water means that if it is in the formation, which means that it has lower salinity than the formation, than the salinity inside the shale or inside the clay in the formation, and in the surface, the fresh water means its salinity no more than 5,000 milligram per liter. So the swelling mechanism, how this occurs? Actually, the clays exist in the nature with a stacked or layered structure. As you know, there are layer, and above it another layer, and above it another layer, and each layer of them has a unit volume, and this unit volume consists of three parallel layers like the silica, aluminate, and another one is silica. So clay exists in nature with a stacked or layered structure, with each unit layer roughly about 10 angstrom thick. Each clay layer is very thin, okay, and has a huge surface area. This huge surface area has a water envelope around it. In the fresh water, the layers adsorb water on its surface and swell. Then, after swelling, something called the increase, or this makes increase in the number of particles, with the resulting increase in the surface area, which causes something like the suspension happened to the particles, and so it gives the thickening properties to the total fluid. Okay, to the total fluid. So they are acting like colloidal or something like this. So they are disintegration happened to it, and this disintegration happened to it in a smaller surface area. And this surface area, each one of them has its water envelope, and so they become thickening, or become viscous or something like this. The relationship and the size and surface area. Here there is 20 micron solid surface. Okay, its area is 2400 microns. The same solid cut into the half for each face. Okay, and here cut into half again of each face. So this makes, if you have here one water envelope, okay, it will never thicken. But what happens is that each one, when some disintegration happened to the particles, okay, between the unit layers, so the water envelopes come from here, and then after this, it is more than more disintegration. This disintegration is more due to the agitation or something like this. So to make a swelling, you are mixing the mud with the bentonite, water with the bentonite, and you have at least from 6 to 8 hours of agitation in order to make them thickening and to become viscous. So that this is the mechanism of the swelling. The cation effects. Okay, take care here that there are two different types, as I told you, of montmorillonite, which are swelling. As I told you, there is calcium montmorillonite and there is sodium montmorillonite, and which one of them has the high swelling than the other? Actually, the sodium is more swelling than the calcium. Why? Because calcium here cannot make. For example, here this is the clay has only one charge on its larger on its surface. Okay. And here also it has just negative charge on its outer surface. So this layer has one negative and this one has one negative. So calcium makes tighten to both of them, or make a bond with both of them, so that once there is some water coming inside or something like this, there are coming water coming inside, calcium cannot make increase in the distance between both of them because it has two charges, or it's divalent. Okay, so that its swelling is not high. This is the angstrom 12.1, and after swelling it's 17 angstrom. So the calcium associated with two layers, and it has limited swelling and dispersion. Also, it has less surface area and associated water. But for the sodium here, as you see here, the sodium, only one sodium can attach to one layer. This sodium also attached to one layer, and this one to one layer, and this another one to one layer instead of the calcium. So once we add the water, and make agitation, okay, each one of them can be separated, each layer with the adsorbent cation can be separated alone in its way, and so that the swelling occurs. And as you see here, this is 9.8 angstrom between the two layers, but here there is 40 angstrom or to the infinity between the two layers. As I told you, that the sodium here has plus one, and here the surface of the layer has negative one, so they can make just one as just adsorption, and so that the water can make them to thicken more and more, and so that it Na is very active more than the calcium. Na associated with only one layer, it has a high potential or high hydration potential, and encourage hydration and layer separation. And this is here, as you see, this is hydrated clay with water envelope, as you see here. As this is layer of the clay, and this is another layer of the clay. This has negative, and this has another negative. Once this Na has adsorbed on the surface, they make swelling between them, and each one of them went to this go up and this go down, and so that both of them make thickening and increase the activity of this type of shale. For example here, assume this is sodium or calcium montmorillonite. Once they are adding water, as you see here, this is the sodium. The water envelope is very big. Okay, the water envelope here is very big, and here the same. But here the calcium is very little. As I told you, due to the calcium is attached to two layers, so it is not. It doesn't have high swelling like the sodium montmorillonate. The cation exchange capacity, and this is the test can be done with something is called MBT or methylene blue test. We will talk about this later, inshallah. The compensating cations that are adsorbed on the unit layer surface may be exchanged for other cations and are called exchangeable cations of the clay. Here is a semictite, or the montmorillonite is the highest one, which has 80 to 150, and here illite is from 10 to 40, chlorite from 10 to 40, and kaolinite is the least one from 3 to just 10. Okay, clay interactions. This is very important question. The clay interaction. Actually, there are four clay interactions. Number one is aggregation. The aggregation where the clay is in its dry state. So the aggregation happens in the dry state of the clay, and the platelets are stacked face-to-face association. It's a face-to-face association like the deck of cards. Dispersion, when the dry clay is placed into fresh water without agitation. Without agitation, okay? So the buckets adsorb water and hydrate and swell. Then after agitation, the swollen buckets disintegrate into individual plates and or smaller buckets. Also, the dispersion happens. Number three, flocculation. Flocculation, when it happens, when agitation is stopped, the clay platelets will be mutually attracted in edge to edge or edge to face association. This forces a structure similar to a house of cards. And the defloculation, okay, if an ionic anionic chemical thinner, for example, difluculant, is added, such as lignosulfonate or chromophyll lignite or something like this, it makes neutralization to the positive edges charges on the clay platelets, and they become neutralized, and so that there is a repulsion forces between the particles, and so that defloculation occurs. As you see here, this is aggregation. This is face-to-face tagged. This is, has here, for example, negative energy and is a negative charge, and this has positive one. So they are like the deck of cards, as you see here. This is called aggregation. And this is dispersion after making, after adding water and make agitation. This is called dispersion. That's what happens. And there is flocculation. Flocculation. Flocculation, for example, this, as I told you, that the clay has charges on the edges and the charge on the surface. So here, if this, the edge here has negative and the surface here has positive, so they will make face-to-face, as you see here, edge-to-face or edge-to-edge. This is called flocculation. And the defloculation, what happens when you add thinner so that it makes a neutralization to the surface, and so that become the repulsion force, and each one of them is defloculated. This is the aggregated state, as you see here. Okay, this is positive here, and this is negative in the other side. It is attached to the positive here and the negative one, and until reaching to all of them. So each one of them has positive here and negative here, and has also positive on the edge. Okay, but they are dealing with the surface charges. Okay. The dispersed bentonite, as you see, there is no interaction between them, but each one of them in its state away from the other one. This is called the flocculation. What is the flocculation? This, as you see here, the surface here has negative negative charge, but the edge here, for example, has positive charge. So they make, like, as you see here, positive of the edge to the negative of the surface, so that this is called the flocculation. And the most important parameter that encourages the flocculation is called the calcium. That's why we have to get rid of the calcium as much as possible, because the calcium make the flocculation, as you see here. Okay, this flocculation, and after them they are they went out from the any reaction, because they become very thick. Or they can be separated from the system while making interaction for the clay. Okay. Also, how can we get use, or how can we exploit the phenomena of flocculation of the calcium? Actually, if we have here sodium montmorillonite, and the company man asks you, instead of 6 hours of agitation, we need hummy to get hives. Actually, we are adding something is called lime. This lime, as you see here, the after adding water, there is here high water envelope, and so that when we add lime, there is cation exchange happened for Na. Each two layers of has Na is displaced with one of Ca, and that as you see here, and the final water envelope is less than that of the here Na montmorillonite, so that it becomes thickened more than that. But actually, this type of flocculation it doesn't give real data or real good parameters for the clay, but it just make visual data. Some polymers are added to the clay to make flocculation, as you see here. Some defloculant also are made. Some defloculant or thinners are added to the clay, especially something is called dispersion. So it maximizes the electrostatic repulsion forces. As you see here, it makes neutralization to the surface. As you see it here, the edge is, for example, has positive, and this has negative. And so it makes a neutralization, and this is neutralized also, this is neutralized, this is neutralized. So each one of them has repulsion forces between each other, and they become defloculated. Encapsulation with BHBA, for example, as you see here, the BHBA has negative charge, but the outer surface of the clay, for example, has a positive charge, so it attaches from one side and it wraps around it, for example, like this, because it has very large or high molecular weight, and this is very low, so it makes like it makes encapsulation. Finally, the clay problems are the swelling and the dispersion. The clay dispersion, the semictite has swelling clay in fresh water, sensitive, and takes water and expand. The mixed layers, okay, it swells but not at the same degree as semictite. The illite disperses in fresh water. The kaolinite, it's subject to dispersion, not the same degree as illite. And chlorite, it is not fresh water sensitive, and it doesn't swell and have higher iron content. Thank you very much for this lesson, and I hope inshallah to give you another lesson later. If this video appeals to you, share, like, subscribe, and see you later inshallah in the polymer chemistry. Thank you very much.